I'm going to spend the next 15 to 20 minutes talking to you about building Windows Mixed Reality applications with Unity. So hopefully people here are familiar with Windows Mixed Reality or virtual reality. If not, I'm going to give you a really quick intro, and then we're going to talk about building experiences with Unity. So for those of you not familiar with mixed reality, that is the term that Microsoft uses when we talk about the spectrum of experiences that we can have. On one side, we have physical reality, where you are probably familiar with augmented reality experience. And on the other side, we have pure digital reality, where you know, you're familiar with potentially virtual reality, where you put on a headset and they take you somewhere else to a different world. So with Microsoft, we use the terms mixed reality because we want to have experiences that expand across the whole continuum. You can write one experience that goes from augmented reality all the way to virtual reality. So that's the term we use. That's just some terminology for you to be familiar with. What does that mean for you with regards to a user experience? Well, you can explore your environment. You can be right here in this room and interact with the floor, interact with the walls, interact with everything else, and bring digital objects or holograms into this space. That's what we call it, mixed reality. So on our side, today I'm gonna show you the immersive headsets, which are the virtual reality headsets. These are occluded, so you're gonna, like with these, we can take you to a different world instead of with maybe using the HoloLens, which you're probably familiar with, where we show you holograms that come into the physical world from the digital world. So today we're gonna talk about the mixed reality or immersive headsets, because last October we launched with partners 5 or 6 new different headsets. So today I'm gonna show you the Acer, but Samsung has a headset, Asus has a headset, HP and Lenovo, they both have virtual reality headsets that you can use, and it's the exact same platform. So everything you learn about developing a game today for mixed reality is gonna apply to any of those headsets the exact same. You don't have to touch any of your code. So how is our mixed reality offering different from everybody else's? Well, the one thing that we have is we're very, very easy to set up. If you're looking at here, this environment, there's no lighthouses, there's no, there's nothing tracking my controller. We're actually using the inside-out tracking technology that we have in HoloLens. So to get disconnected, all I did was connect my HDMI port and my USB port, and that's it. So I can carry these to 30 feet from now, I can take it back to my hotel room, and I don't have to have any lighthouses or anything set up. That's what Microsoft is doing with our mixed reality experiences, and that makes it really convenient for some scenarios like commercial, enterprise scenarios, you know, training. Users who don't want to put lighthouses in their living room, they can use these and get the exact same experience as a virtual reality without having to make any compromises. The other thing that makes us different is that with our platform, you write the application once, and it can run across a myriad of devices. So for example, if you have an Xbox game, and you want to convert it to mixed reality, you're using the exact same platform, the exact same tools, pretty much everything that you're already familiar with. You're submitting to the exact same store, and you're using everything that you're already familiar with. So we have one ecosystem that you would actually be able to use. Same thing for the store. We have one store where every Windows user will have the same store. So for example, you know, Windows 10 has 500 million users out there that are constantly going to the store and then downloading like casual games, or they're downloading enterprise apps, but it's the exact same store. So when they go to the store, they can discover your game and find it very quickly, and then install it from there. So it's a really good way for you to get discovery. And they can buy other things like books and media, videos. So the store is a place that they visit very often. So it's a good way for you to get discovered. So that's what mixed reality is. So now let me show you how easy it is to take a Windows Unity game and actually port it to mixed reality. And the game I'm going to show you today, it's called Laser Cup, and it's one of the Unity samples, so that everybody here who's familiar with Unity can go download the sample and see it, and you know, see how easy it is to port it. So before we start, one of the things that you might want to know is what are the prerequisites for you to write a mixed reality game, or for users to run your mixed reality games. And it's very simple. All we need is Windows 10, which is the latest version of Windows. The File Creators Updates is the one we released last October, and that's, you know, so you just need to have the latest version of Windows. And then you as a developer will need Visual Studio, which you can use Community Edition, and it's free. And then in this case, we're going to talk about Unity, so you can use Unity, which again also has a professional license, but they also have a personal license that you can use and not have to pay anything for you to use it if you're using as an indie, or you're a student or something similar where you're not using it for commercial use from a large enterprise. So getting started is super, super simple. So with that, let me show you what our game looks like and how we would take it and target Windows Mixed Reality. So the game right here is in Unity. And what I have right here is this game. It's called Laser Cop. And first, I'm going to show it to you as Unity ships it, which is for Gear VR. So before I make any changes, you'll see the game as we play it. So I'm going to go right here into Unity. And just out of the default, I'm going to use the game as written for Gear VR, but I'm going to try to get it to run on our headset. So what you have to do in order to get it to run on our headsets is very simple. You go into Unity and just change your build settings. So I can come back here and set File, Build Settings. And here in this case, if it was Gear VR, it would say it's for Android, for Gear VR. Or if it was Steam VR or Rift, it would say it's for PC. And all I have to do is select right here Universal Windows Platform. And that's going to make it target our Universal Store, which is, again, what we use for any Universal app, whether it's HoloLens, Mixed Reality, or Xbox. And then you would just do Switch Platform here. I already done that for you because that takes a few seconds. And that automatically makes it target Windows Universal Platform. And then the last thing that I want to do is go into Player Settings and tell the game that we're going to use Mixed Reality. So the way to do that is you go right here into XR Settings. And then you just check Mixed Reality. Here, if I had multiple SDKs, like for example, Rift or Steam, I would actually have those SDKs listed here. In this case, we're only going to default to Mixed Reality, so that's the only one we're going to use. And that's it. Those two settings are all I have to do in order for me to be able to play the game in my headset. So now you can see what the game plays like in the headset. So I can just go back here in Unity and then just say play. And obviously, this is going to be the editor play experience, but you'll see right here. It's going to come up, and hopefully you see part of the game. You're going to see only one eye, as opposed to a missing and two eyes in the headset, but you see the game right here, and you see that... For some reason, it didn't find my controller. So you see the game right here, and you see that, for example, right now, there's no controller because this game was written for Gear VR. So even though it's doing the tracking, the controller model is not listed there. And the controller is still interactable. I can click play and do all the right things. So in this case, that's the game as it started. And if I go back here and show you this experience right here, you'll see the Gear VR controller. So I'm just going to switch here to the original scene. And you'll see the exact same scene. Unity just crashed. Sorry, guys. I have a 2017 dot version of Unity, which should be pretty stable, but for some reason it crashed that time. So let me just restart Unity real quick. That has nothing to do with Mixed Reality. That's just Unity. Do you guys use Unity? So you know that that's true. It doesn't happen that often, but it does happen. So I'm going right here, exact same experience. Going to Unity, I'm going to open the original experience, the original scene. And just make sure the settings are the same, which it should have saved in automatically because they were already saved. And now you can see the game. So you can see here, this is actually now showing you the Gear controller. So even though it's actually using a Microsoft controller, it shows you the Gear controller because that's how Unity wrote it. So you can see here, I can click play, and then it turns into a lightsaber, and then the game is called Laser Cop. And it's about these people that are attacking me. For example, they're sending these bombs, and I can just kill them. And then these drones are going to shoot every now and then. And with the laser, I can just deflect what they're shooting. So that's what the game is about. And we're going to just port it very quickly to Windows Mixed Reality. So I'm going to stop it there because that's the Gear VR game. And then we're going to convert it to Windows Mixed Reality. We've already done one half of the equation, which was the, targeting Windows Mixed Reality. The next thing that I'm going to show you is how to do controllers. What you have to change with your code in order to use the Windows Mixed Reality controllers. And before I do that in code, I'm going to give you a little bit of the options of how do we target so that you get familiar with the APIs before that. So some people ask, well, given that Microsoft is using their own tracking and it's inside-out tracking, do I have to do anything different for a tracking of Mixed Reality? And the answer is no. You use the standard Windows APIs as you were using them for Gear or for Rift, and everything works the exact same. So you don't have to change anything for the headset. The controller, as you saw earlier in the game that I showed you, it was already tracking automatically, and it was doing everything as if it was Gear VR headset or a mixed reality headset. There's nothing special that you have to do. When it comes to controllers, we do give you a few more options. Our platform ships with this Windows UI special interaction, which is what you would use if you were writing a DirectX app or your own platform, your own game, maybe an OpenGL game. But since you're using Unity, you can use the Unity APIs, and there Unity gives you two options. One of them is you can use the Unity input tracking APIs. If you've ever written a Gear experience, a Rift or Steam experience, you've actually used that API. That's the OpenXR API, and that still works with our platform. So that means you shouldn't have to change your game at all. Now, if you want to use our APIs, the Windows APIs, you can also use this new API that Windows offers, that Unity wraps, called Interaction Manager, and that gives you a little bit more functionality. In a minute, I'm going to show you what the extra functionality is. So there's just a few extra features that you can have. And also, for those of you who are using SDKs like BRTK or Newton VR or any of the open source SDKs out there that people use for writing cross-platform Windows or virtual reality experience, you can use any of those the same. We have support for all of them, so within Windows Mixed Reality. So with regards to what Interaction Manager gives you, they just give you an extra pose. For example, you have a pointer pose that comes out of the pointer right here, and a grip pose, and that's the only thing that's different. Today I'm going to use the grip pose so that you can see the functionality exactly as it comes out of the controller. So let's go back to the experience and then add a couple changes so that we can swap it to use our controllers. So I'm going to go back here to Unity. And this is our original experience as we had it. So let me show you what the Windows Mixed Reality experience looks like and what I changed to make the controllers work. So here I'm opening the exact same scene, and the only thing that I've done is I made a couple changes. Here on the player ring, you see they have the left hand where the controllers were, and here they had all these physical like game objects that were the Gear VR controllers. So all I did is I disabled all of this. So I hid all of the Gear VR controllers, and then I added this track controller script that comes from the Windows Mixed Reality, the virtual reality toolkit that we have, which is Microsoft Mixed Reality Toolkit. And all I did is added the functionality to the controller, and then I told it which hand to track. So in this case, I'm doing the left hand. And then I told it to render the system controller. And the reason we do that is because in our case, because Microsoft has headsets that come from Samsung and HP and Asus, the controllers or the headsets can be slightly different. So if we're going to render a controller model, you want to query it from the system and tell the system to give you the controller model. And that's what this script does. All it does is it actually goes in and says, ask the driver, hey, give me the controller model, and then it renders it on Unity. So it's trivial for you to do. It's a few lines of code for you to add, and then that's all I had to do for us to have mixed reality support within this Laser Cup game. So now I can come back here and play the game. And you'll see that now it will render the controller, and you can see right here, now it's rendered a mixed reality controller, and all the animations and everything else is there. And the controller still works. So for example, if I click play again, it turns into and everything's worked. So there we have the controller model. We need to actually convert it. We can have Windows Mixed Reality in your code. Again, if you have a game for Steam or for Rift or for Gear VR, it should be pretty easy for you, if it's written in Unity, to convert it into Windows Mixed Reality. And now you have a game that's ready for Windows Mixed Reality. You can submit it to the Windows Store and get a lot more users to see your game and to install your game and give you the money. So that's how easy it is to convert a mixed reality game, and that's what our platform is about. So let me go back here just quickly. Now, obviously, I want to keep it very short, so I only show you how to do controllers, but there's other things that you would have to do. You saw earlier that the headset tracking works automatically, so you don't have to do anything extra for gaze. But gaze is something that we use in Windows a lot, so make sure that you use gaze when you write your game. Another thing that we have is voice. With Microsoft, because of HoloLens, a lot of our users that use Windows Mixed Reality are used to talking to the controller, to talk into the headset. So make sure if you write your game that you implement voice. It's super trivial. It's, again, a few lines of code, just like the ones that I showed you, to convert it and to do mixed reality. On top of that, the next thing that you would want to do is maybe replace your assets. So for example, you want to do replace your splash screen so that when your Windows experience comes up, you get a nice Windows splash screen. We have this thing called 3D launchers, which is something that you see in our cliff house. Let me show you what our cliff house looks like so you can get familiar with those a little bit. So I'm going to go right here, and I'm going to navigate into our cliff house. If you've never seen what the Windows Mixed Reality Home, this is what the Windows Mixed Reality Home looks like. So I'm right here, you're seeing the cliff house, which is where I put all my applications, and navigating with the controller, I can do things like teleport. I can interact with everything in the cliff house. So for example, I can interact with this object right here, and it's animated, and that's actually an icon for an application. So that's what 3D launchers are. So for example, right here, I can be in there, and I can navigate within the cliff house, and you can see here, for example, this is the holograms application, and that's a 2D slate, as we call it. So that's the icon for the application, but that's a 2D icon. You can also get 3D icons. So for example, if I walk right here into the media room, you can walk right here and you'll see, for example, this is the icon right here for the Hulu application, or for example, that's the icon for Jump VR, and this is the icon for the White House, the People's House, which is a video experience that you can use from Felix and Paul. And so that's the icon, and you can see here, I can interact with them, I can move them around. So that's what 3D launchers, that's one of the things that you would want to do if you port your application to Windows Mixed Reality. You want to have a really nice 3D launcher that people can use it to decorate their cliff house as they go. So that's one of the things that you would have to do. So the rest of it, the last thing that I want to highlight that you would want to show from your experience, if you're going to port the experience, is this. With Windows Mixed Reality, we actually support a very wide gamut of hardware. So if you're familiar with Steam or Rift, mostly with Steam, you're only supporting high-end hardware. Like Steam only runs in like, you know, a GTX 970 card, video card or above. With Windows Mixed Reality, because we have a broader set of experiences and a broader set of users, we allow you to run, like, we allow users to run Mixed Reality in lower-end PCs. So for example, if you're, all you're doing is rendering a 360 video experience, that can run fine on an Intel GPU. And with Windows Mixed Reality, we let you do that. So when you put submit your application to our store, you need to make sure you decide, hey, I want to target the, what we call a mainstream PC. And if you do that, you just check a box, and then anybody who has a mainstream PC can actually run it, and that way you get more users for your application. So that's one of the other things that you would have to tweak. And that's literally all you have to look at. Like, those are the high-level things that you would have to do if you wanted to convert your mixed reality experience. If you want to learn more about how to get started, the easiest way to do it is to go to aka.msiwantamar. And there what you do is, if you have an experience, you profile your experience there, you tell them who you are, you tell them what your application is, if it's Steam or something, you give them a link. And then once you do that, they from there will send you a developer kit. So you get the same Acer kit that I'm showing you with the controllers for free. So you, as long as you have an application that you want to port, they'll profile you there, and if they think, you know, your application will be a good candidate for us to port, they'll send you the kit for free, and then they'll give you access to newsletters and developer resources. So if you have questions, so that, you know, you need some help with somebody porting your experience or something, you actually get developer resources, people you can call, real people that you can talk to on the phone, not just forums, and they can help you with porting your experience. It's super easy, and most experiences can be ported in like a week to a month. We have a lot of experience. We do these at hackathons a lot, and people have a really good experience porting, and it's relatively fast, and then you can get discovery in the Windows Store, so you have a new distribution channel for your application. So that's it for me today. I'm happy to take any questions if you want to come up to the front and ask me any questions about anything you saw, and I can go into more details on the things that I didn't show you. So thank you very much for coming, guys. Yep.